Welcome to my channel, The Way to Succulents. I'm your host, The Way. As always, I would love to share my way of being succulent with you. Today, I would love to share one beauty, which is called Echeveria agavitis, which is also commonly called lipstick succulents. Let's first go with the Latin name. Look at her. It's a rosette. Normally, a rosette shape succulents is a type of Echeveria. And agavitis. You may say, oh, it sounds like agave. Yes, it means looks like agave. Like I mentioned, it's also commonly called lipstick succulent. You may say, why? Have a look at the tips. It's kind of with red color. The camera doesn't so well, but look at the leaf. You see the tip, it's red. It's kind of like lipsticks. Yes, that's why. This plant is originally from Mexico. It's found from a piece of big rocky land area. So it's not picky with soil. As long as it has a good drainage system, it's happy. It loves sun. This is the guy you can just plant underneath the sun for the whole day. It wouldn't even get sunburnt. And you may say whether it's a hardy one or not. No, it's not a hardy one. Don't put them out in the winter time. If you live somewhere like me, I live in Wisconsin, zone 5. In the winter time, everywhere is covered by snow. No, they would die. This is also a plant that grows really quick and happy. Look at this. These are the offsets, the babies. And that's a bigger one. From this size, growing to this size, it just needs 1 year. And you may wonder like how big exactly it grows. The height of it doesn't go very, very tall. It's around 5 inches tall, which is around 12 centimeters tall. But it grows big, wide. It is said that the biggest one, the mature one, grows as big as 12 inches wide, by diameter, I mean, which is 60 centimeters by diameter. That's quite a big one. So you do need to give it a good space if you want a big rosette, another big rosette. And it's a solitary plant. It's always by itself. That actually makes it prettier. About planting this one, you can see this ball, the planter, there's no hole. At first, just about it like a soup bowl. I love the pattern, look at it. And when I got this agavitis, I said, no, that would be perfect for her. So I say, okay, I will put her in. What I did is I put a thick layer of lava rocks underneath. And then I put this plant in. Normally, some people like to change the soil when after they bought the plant. I don't. I put the whole thing in. Then I add some more rocks, some more soil rocks together to surround it, to compose a really good drainage. And it still have the soil to grow, but not too much. And the rocks are really important for them too. It's kind of like you give them the room to breathe. That's important. And the water go down, and then when I water this guy, I mean, when I water this type of pot without a hole, I'm super careful. I don't give it a lot of water. And you may see, when do you water it? I touch the middle layer of the leaves, not the bottom one. The middle layer of the leaves. When it's soft, I kind of can fold it. That means, yes, I'm thirsty, please water me. The bottom one, because when they grow, look at this one. When the new one grow, the bottom one, they give way to the new one. And in the springtime, I would suggest you to get rid of these bottom leaves. Otherwise, they would compose problem like scales, millibugs they hide underneath. That's not good for them. And you may say, oh, for these leaves, can I propagate? The bottom dry leaves, normally it cannot produce a baby anymore. Only really like the really healthy one would give you a baby. And for this plant, there are 3 ways to propagate. The first is just go with the really, really bottom. Sorry, I need to put on my gloves. It's important for people when you work with succulents or plants, put on your gloves. It's good for us because a couple of days ago, I watched a picture of a lady. She shared she was dealing with a type of succulent, euphorbia. She didn't wear any gloves, and then she rubbed her eyes. And just a couple of minutes later, her eyes and her face are swollen so badly. Unfortunately, she doesn't have any medical insurance. She didn't keep posting about what's going on, but I'm wondering, like, what's going on? Is she okay, or she need go to a hospital, and how much it costs? That's horrible. So wear gloves is good for us. It's also good for the plants. When you touch this, you touch that, and then actually your hand is with something. Something maybe the plants don't like, so wear gloves. I have all different types. This, the rubber one for the really tough one, the long sleeve one to protect myself. So please, wear gloves. Let's go back. Tweak the leaves from the really, really stem, the bottom part, near the stem off, instead of otherwise, if you break it from the middle like this, it might give you a baby, but the possibility is only about 50%. If you tweak it off from the stem, really, really bottom, it will give you 95% chance. I wouldn't promise 100% because I do have some dead leaves. Even though they look healthy, it doesn't promise you anything. That's the first way. The leaves would give you new plants, new babies. The second way is look at this. Like this one, this one. During the flower season, it gives you another surprise. That is the offside of this plant. And you do need to cut them off, otherwise even if they grow, they don't look so good anymore. And use scissors like this, or of course other scissors works too. The better way is go the same, go all the way to the bottom and cut it off like this. Let it, you can play with them like me, I wear them all the time. Let them fully callous and plant them, you will get a beautiful plant. And the third way is, they call it cutting. It's also kind of offside, personally to me. That is when they, it's kind of like hung on cheeks. When they grow here, this is the one grow at the side. And then you can just cut it off, a cutting. And the same, fully callous and plant. That's all. This is the amazing part. For the seeds, some people, like you see these flowers, will open soon, it will just come out soon. It's kind of like this, the shape is like a star when it's fully open. And some people collect the seeds and then they grow succulents from the seeds. It works, but really low chance. Some people are really lucky, they have really good green hands and they made it. I tried twice and I failed, so I actually like the other way of propagation. What about you? Leave a comment if you like. Did I tell you it's not a hardy guy? It can bear 20 degrees Fahrenheit, which is around -6 degrees centigrade. If you plant them outside, when the temperature goes down like this, take them back in. I mentioned before frost, take them back in. Otherwise, you can just use a blanket to cover them, to protect them. It works because where I live in Wisconsin, like last October, it was super cold and it was with frost. November, it warmed up and it was like September. So it's sometimes it's hard to tell when to bring them back. But before frost, the weather forecast always tell you like there is a frost, so bring them back or just cover them. I like to cover them because I want to leave them outside as the ground cover as long as possible. What about you? This guy here, let me see what is the white thing. I don't like to use little rocks, especially the white gravel rocks as a cover. What do you call it? I don't like to use these because, like I mentioned before, it will make the air stuck in and it's not breathable. It's dangerous for them. This is a shell necklace I bought when I travel and I never ever wear them again. But when I saw them, I said, yeah, they are beautiful necklaces for them as well. So I use a lot of things I bought when I travel and then, yeah, they can better use them now. Thank you for watching my video. Hopefully you enjoyed it. And please subscribe my channel. I will share more and more. information about being with succulents. Bye for now.